Welcome back, Dark Souls fans. Left that horribly in Dark Souls 3, and I think Ashes of Ariandel and I kind of got off on the wrong foot. So watch my housemate play this a bit, and I realize, you know what? This is actually not so bad. I may have been a bit too hard on it at first. So let's keep going. Let's not let the initial issues cloud things too much. Let's just stab a giant enemy crab, shall we? Or two. And forget the not playing Monster Hunter and don't get free dodges. Oops. But yeah, so, you know, this is actually a pretty okay thing, I think, overall. I just kind of had the wrong attitude going into it. I don't know what I was thinking, but yeah. It's nice to watch somebody else play it. It really helps provide some perspective, I think. Because otherwise you're just going off and thinking, oh, I'm doing this, and it's just, I don't know, it feels worse, I guess, just to have, be yourself. That's the only thing, the only person playing it. And then you see how they approach it. Actually, one of the big things is that arrow thing that was really wrecking me. Like that big exploding arrow. I noticed, you know, the way I went through it, I got kind of unlucky that I got knocked onto a branch. And then had to deal with it because my housemate just got into a platform because it kind of went in the more obvious order, and that left it more of a thing that could be easily dealt with. Like the way I went through with it, I ended up getting knocked onto a branch and then getting hit by the arrow out of nowhere. Whereas if you go and attack the enemies as they are obvious, you end up getting onto the right platforms and you get hit by an arrow when you're relatively safe, and that works out. So my complaints about the design were a little bit premature, I will grant. And now I stab you in your weak point for massive damage! It doesn't kill, apparently. Ah, there we go! Oh. Nope, I was right the first time, it doesn't kill. But you're still dead. Crystal gem? I've had those before, right? Yeah, I've had those before. I thought I had, but I wasn't entirely sure. Alright, so, what's down here? What's my health like? My health's okay. Magic, on the other hand, is a little bit lacking. So we have, it looks like a cave, and I want to go to the high ground, because, you know, always go to the high ground. And you have little blue feet, so I know you're bad. That's the thing. Look for the snow at the bottom. Look for the snow at the base. That's how you know that they're the ones that are actually trying to kill you, and not just slightly annoying. Like, see, that one, for instance, is going to try to kill me, but it's an ice one. So I don't really care. It can do its thing. That one, however, is right in front of me. So I do care. Oh, crap. There's a grab attack. That's not a grab attack. That's a spear attack. Thank you for using the spear attack. It's much less of a pain than the grab attack, because the grab attack is usually fatal, and that spear was not. Oh, where does this go? Come on, breathe, you. Alright. That was your death sentence. Thank you. I appreciate the cooperation. Then that's fire. That can't be the only one, is it? Yep, it is. Whoa. That's a new attack. It's also totally relevant. Ooh, a sorcery. Let's see what it is. Snap Freeze. One of the spells left by the young Sorcerer Sullivan before leaving the Painted World. Ooh. Creates a cloud of near-freezing mist. Sullivan was born and raised inside the painting, yet had little use for his frigid homeland since he had not experienced loss. Okay. That's completely lacking context, actually. I was going to say interesting, but then it occurs to me that, okay, we know what Pontus Sullivan is. Is that annoying boss in Irithyll that you had to fight. It was a pain in the butt. And other than that, it's like, okay, that's a thing. That's kind of interesting that they started here. But I haven't yet figured out the significance of this place. I mean, it's basically just a pocket dimension that can, ooh, a ladder. A pocket dimension that contains a sort of Irithyll-like place. Beyond that, I really don't know. There isn't a whole lot that... What the... Okay. That... Was that a letter here before? That letter wasn't here before. I'm gonna have to check the footage. I think I might have missed that. But yeah, so... Pond of Sullivan. That was a guy. He did some stuff. He took over Irithyll and made the entire religion of Irithyll worship Aldrich. So presumably Aldrich comes from here, I guess. That's the only real way of thinking about it. Because if Aldrich comes from here, then that means that this is much more important. But at this point, I don't really know. It seems like this is all kind of like, oh, well, that's cool. Wait, what does it mean? That looks so neat. Whatever it is. Because honestly, I don't know what the significance of any of that is at this point. All I know is I have a way back. And I guess by extension a shortcut, though admittedly I also have a bonfire. But hey! We found something new about a character that probably no one's thought about for a long time. I know I haven't. Actually, that's not entirely true. I think of Pond of Sullivan all the time. And I'm not kidding. Anytime I get angry, I think, Pond of Sullivan, you bastard. I'm also not kidding, actually. Pond of Sullivan was a very annoying boss. Hey, a Titanite slab! That's much better news! You're not necessarily good news. You're just news. You do exist, you know. You're a oh, hey. Good thing I checked. It's like, oh, hey, ceilings. Bugs sometimes are on ceilings. You're a bug. You're on a ceiling. Logic. And ladders. A good combination. Oh, hey. One of you. Titanite lizard gives me a large titanite shard. Well, I shrug in apathy. I shrug in apathy at you, sir. Oh, I know these remind me of. It's, wow, that was badly timed. I wasn't even paying attention to my health bar. They remind me of the hollows you fight at the very, very, very beginning of Dark Souls 2. Now, not exactly the same, but they remind me of those characters. The ones that you fight as just these hollows that are... They're tutorial world hollows. They're not particularly hard. They're just sort of there. Oh, I guess we can find out a really important question. Yes, they respawn. Of course they respawn. Well, I don't really have to deal with you, so I'm not going to. See, what the heck? Okay, what? I thought that was worse. How the heck do I get to that ladder? That's strange. Because, I went down here. I'm assuming that what I need to do is talk to this guy. Or, by talk, I mean stab several times. Except when it starts swinging around wildly. Ow. This is not throwing fireballs at me. I gotta say, this is preferable. But I'm assuming it's kill this thing. I'm assuming that's the thing that unlocks the ladder. Let's find out for science. And also Estus, because... Yeah, or heal either. Yep, that's the one. That's the thing. That's how you do it. Okay, well, that's not a big deal. That's totally manageable. Yeah, bit of a long climb. But yeah, anyway, so they remind me of the Things Betwixt. That's the thing. The hall is in Things Betwixt. They're actually in Things Betwixt and Forest of Fallen Giants. I think they might be in... No, they're not in Shaded Woods. Yeah, so those two areas. That's basically it. But that's what they remind me of. And kind of a mix of that in the Farron. Obviously, there's some of the Farron helmet style. So they remind me kind of that too, but not so much. The bugs, on the other hand, they're straight out of Bloodborne. And I realize, yes, there was the bug type thing that was in the Profane Capital. I still don't care. I still say Bloodborne. There are those leeches, the Canehurst leeches. Which, admittedly, I also said about the things at the bottom of Profane Capital, because they also reminded me of the Canehurst leeches. although they weren't bloodsuckers. I don't sure if these things are. In fact, I probably should be calling them fly people. Because that's really what they are. They are the sad result of a medieval transporter accident. That's really all that can be said. It's a tragedy. Yeah, they're definitely fly people. Well, all that can be done is to put them down. Get them out of their misery. Especially in amusing ways like that. Yeah. What a shame. So many brundles. So, let's get my souls and pick up the... Pick up where we left off here. With you dying, and me with full health, so I don't have to worry about... There we go, that's better. Whoa, you're not dead yet? I'm impressed. And annoyed. Ah, crap. Okay, seriously? How are you not dead? This is like 1 HP. Alright, that's one. That's two. Okay, there we go. Sheesh, that was way harder than it should have been. Although, I am kind of reminded about the thing I pointed out earlier, but more annoying this time, that it seems like Dark Souls 3 seems to have this problem of stuff doesn't stay done. And it's an issue I actually kind of noticed before, but it's, like, environmental things. I mean, like, environmental changes, stuff breaking, stuff being done, being visible, that sort of thing. I mean, the Crown of the Ivory King DLC in 2 had a similar thing with the ladders, but it was just when you got to a certain point, you got an item that allowed you to see certain ladders that were otherwise hidden. But this is kind of the same thing, except much smaller. Oh, yeah, see, but this shortcut is going to just be there... only for this period, I think. Maybe not. We'll find out. Actually, you know what? No. I'm gonna do something. I got spoiled on one thing, so let's just get that out of the way, just deal with that first, and then we'll move on to the rest of the lower area, which part of what I was spoiled on was that the lower area is the important area. Although, if that ladder is permanent, or at least permanent from the top, you know what? That's a shortcut. Granted, I have a bonfire warp, so shortcuts are kind of irrelevant. And that was kind of a thing that Dark Souls 3 was apparently supposed to avoid doing, and kind of did, was avoid going into as much bonfire. It didn't so much. Bloodborne did a good job with that, or seemed to have. I've yet to play that game. I could, I just have yet to. The situation will change, and then I will be able to. Let's put it that way. And by that way, I mean, like, second PS4 in the house. But... when that happens, I will definitely play Bloodborne in between playing BlazBlue. And of course, that's for Battle Arena, whatever.
Welcome to the painted world of Ariandel. I am Frida. I have long stood beside our blessed father and the rest of the Forlorn. But forlorn thou seemeth not, Lord of Hollows. I know not the missteps which led thee to this painted world. But thy duty is all, and thy duty lieth elsewhere. Return from whence thou camest. I presume it visible to thee? The bonfire here in this room.
That one? Yeah.
A meek and faded thing, but 'twill guide thee nonetheless.
Okay.
Ah, yes. There is a thing thou shouldst by rights possess. A remembrance of this cold world for the great Lord of Londor. May it help thee bear thy duty.
Cool.
Now,
okay, so I guess that's just reduce the amount of frostbite you get. I guess this one, if I wanted to do that. How much frost resistance? So, Chill Bite Ring. One of the bite rings named to Kareem increases frost resistance. This ring would never grace Frida's hand, for the painting and its frost became her home. That's sad. A little sad. Okay, it's actually quite sad. Yeah, that is rather tragic. But, hey, welcome to Dark Souls. Anyway, I don't know. The thing that's really been bothering me with frost is if the trees grab me, and I don't think that's dodgeable by using this. Anyway. I want to see how shortcutty this can be. Time for critical foe. How central is this? I mean, there's a lever inside here too, which... Okay, what the heck? Does that mean the door closes? Is there an elevator here? There must be an elevator or something. I mean, levers like this are generally for elevators, but apparently not in this case. I doubt it's decorative. That's not a thing Dark Souls tends to do. Decoration is for other games. Dark Souls doesn't really do that sort of thing. Not as a rule, at least. So, let's see what's... I mean, the ladder, we know what that brings it down to. But there's still an entire other side I hadn't explored. Oh wait, I guess the ladder was fully explored. Okay, you know what, Oh no, there was, yeah, that's right, yes. I am going this way for a reason. Not just doing it because I want to see what's down here. As like, oh hey, does this shortcut work? Because it's a shortcut. No, I actually want to see genuinely. Because there was a thing I was dropping down to and... Okay, let's somersault. Actually, I think I just hit the roll button. Let's somersault up a ladder. See how that works. See, let me know how that works, Arena. Yeah, just send me a postcard. Okay, where does this lead? Oh, wow. Oh, this is new. Huh. Well, less frosty. Bit of a change, more of a tundra permafrost thing going on here. Not really sure what to expect from this, but we'll find out. Nothing looks deadly yet. Large soul. Hey, that's more not permafrosty stuff. This area is kind of nice. It's kind of a pleasant little reprieve from, you know, everything else trying to kill me. Nothing's tried to kill me for 5 whole seconds. A new record! Although, to be perfectly honest, I'm perfectly glad to try to kill it. Okay. Let's be prudent and kill everything. That's a good way to get through life, I think. Well... Shoot. I gotta still have a few seconds before they really wake up. Wow, what the heck? This seems to be you again! Wait, you're easy. Man, it's like all the bloody Canehurst stuff. Oh. You're not Canehurst at all. You're just weird bird. Like larval bird people? No, not larvae. Birds don't metamorphose through a larval pupil stage. What's the term? A chick. That's what it is. You're like a bird person chick. You're a bird person larva. Man, pupating birds, that'd be a thing to see. Like, and then be possibly turned off eggs forever? But, you know. If you're planning to become an ovo-lacto vegetarian, then it's a good first step. Where's this come from? There's a thing up here, I want to go down to it. Because it looks like I might be able to jump onto that little rock pillar. And I was going up here. And I hear something, or is that inside? I think that's inside. Okay, we'll get to the Titanite Lizard when we get to it. But yeah, this goes up and then goes down. And that should provide some... degree of access to that little rock there, because that little rock there looks interesting, like it actually provides something. What do you provide, little rock? Okay. Let's see, more larval and pupal birds. Oh, that's how you get to it. Okay, well, more birds died, so I guess that's a success. Or weird bird people things. What do you say? Silence ahead. Like, I can't cast spells, silence? No, they're being ironic. Of course they are. Because, yeah. When an entire field full of things that's they're screaming to wake up their comrades. Of course they're gonna joke about silence. And hey, it's blood! Bet you haven't seen that before in a game like this. So, it almost looks like it's like blood barnacles. Yeah, these are like barnacles. Except they're land barnacles. Well, you're annoying. You're also totally locked down, so have fun with that. Oh crap. Ow! Wow. And that's why we have the crossbow. Hey, a Titanite chunk! I got a thing I wanted! Finally! Gave me something good. I guess that's what those things metamorphose into, is their adult form. So it's like, these are the caterpillars, and that horrible blade thing is the butterfly. I mean, man, you're worried about moths eating your clothes. And would you look at that? It's a ladder! How novel! I haven't had to have those before. Thankfully, it's a short ladder. Not quite the ridiculous ladder we had to deal with before, although admittedly, you were all spared. I was not. What's on the roof? Something's gonna jump down at me. I hear you. Oh, you're in the other room. You are in the other room, right? And hey, it's an ember. Ah, there you are. Okay, what am I hearing? I'm hearing something. Not deaf. Are you in the desks? Have you taken up accountancy? Marshall accountancy? What? Oh shoot, I'm sorry. I thought you were hostile.
Well, there is nothing forlorn about you.
Aggressive and uncool for fashion, maybe.
Other Ash, I suppose.
Yeah, let's go with that.
Oh, finally, you have come. Oh, wondrous Ash, grant us our wish. Make the tales true, and burn this world away. My lady must see flame. And you have only to show her. You are Ash, are you not? Is it not fire that you seek?
Sure, but I throw lightning, not fire.
Surely you've seen the rot that afflicts our world.
Tell me what else is new.
But that which fooled the good father and buried the flame. After we had all made up our minds, too. So, please, grant us one wish. Make the tales true, and burn this world away. My lady?
Right.
Oh, I am so terribly frightened of timidly rotting away, like those fools on the outside.
Right, so I'm guessing witch for, like, the fire witches, and then father must be Pontiff? Sullivan? Like... I guess so. You hostile? You are apparently not hostile. Okay, well, I see no reason to kill you then. Well, that's been... definitely a much more pleasant experience of the Ashes of Ariandel DLC. So, yeah, all right. I was a bit harsh on it at first, but yeah, this is... After getting through the wolves, getting out of the woods... Man, that opening, I mean, I gotta say, that's... That is, like, I guess what they must have thought was, people who haven't played Dark Souls in a while are gonna play this, and people who haven't played Dark Souls in a while, they're gonna be a little bit out of it. They're not necessarily gonna remember, you know, how Dark Souls works as a game. Now, granted, I actually have been playing on a different character, but still, it's... And a much lower level character and a totally different playstyle. So yeah, it's like, you know, you might forget exactly how Dark Souls works. It's, you know, it's Dark Souls. And then the game goes, this is Dark Souls, remember? And then makes you remember in a way that you can't forget. Okay, there's a shortcut. That's apparently also a shortcut. Okay, whatever. Probably drop down from a... What the heck are you... See, I'm trying to be nice to you guys. I could kill all of you if I felt like it, but I don't. You know, I thought it'd be nice for once. Oh, what the? Nope. Okay, well, so much for charity. And you clearly just want crossbow bolts to the face. I can oblige. They aren't that expensive, and they're the only thing I have to spend souls on, so you get the crossbow. Whoa, 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 whoa. Not gonna go down there again if I don't have to. I might have to. I imagine I probably will at some point have to, but for now, let's stay above the rivers of blood, shall we? Oh, I think that's past the gate, actually. I think that, yeah! Yeah, that's the gate, isn't it? Or, yes, it is. Okay, so yes, I could go past the gate. Tempting. Not sure how I get back. I mean, I guess I have the coiled ember, you know. Homeward bone back, as it were. That's always an option. Before I do want to see if there's anything I'm missing. Like an entire colony of forlorn birds. That's a thing. Oh. Being murdered by one of those blade bastards. Whoa! Well, if I could just target the guy. Oh man, this is painful. Ow! Oh, come on. Okay. Why am I not dodging? Ah! Man, you're annoying. Just like, give me 2 seconds. Seriously, what the heck? Whatever, I'll lock you down then. Ah! No, I... What the heck?! Locked me down? I lock you down! That's how it works! I'm the one who locks people down! Got it? Some people just don't know things. Don't know how the world works. Barbarians. Hey, well. Try to look against that thing again. Can't say I'm remarkably confident, but... Whatever, what have I got to lose? Would you stop making me target things that are ostensibly my friends? What did I say about lockdown? Agh! Well, I was right. I just didn't have the crossbow bolt loaded. I learned from my mistake. Like, I'm kind of used to my other character. The thing is, like I said, I haven't played this character in a while. The other character, one thing I found is interesting about Dark Souls, because Dark Souls 3 in particular, because reloading and firing and crossbow are two different actions, the best way to do, say, dual crossbow, which the other character does primarily, is to have 4 crossbows and then switch them, because it's faster to switch weapons than it is to reload them. Oh, for crying out loud, stupid targeting system. Fine. Playing mouse and keyboard anyway. I don't see why I have to use the lock-on targeting to begin with. Except, of course, because... the game doesn't really handle the mouse well. Now, what did I tell you about lockdowns? Ow. Stupid wall. What the heck is with this range? How did that not hit? It's taking way too many tries. But yeah, I'm kind of used to just having four bolts at the ready all the time. So going down to one is a little bit disorienting, in all honesty. Although, to be perfectly honest, that character is having a hard time with the Deacons of the Deep of all boss fights, so... Mind you, that is no surprise. Deacons of the Deep are a boss fight... Well, there's a couple of reasons. One is actually on display here, which is that the lock-on target system is not very good at knowing what you actually want to target. Like, it doesn't necessarily target to the center of the screen. It seems to bias based on distance before going for angle. Oh... How was I supposed to avoid that? Game's bugging me. But yeah, so it goes by distance before angle, so when you're dealing with 40 somewhat beefy enemies, like it takes 4 or 5 shots to kill them, and you can't target the one you want to target, and non-lock-on targeting for ranged weapons is this finicky mess, yeah, it's a real pain. Like, it really starts to see a lot of the issues with the game, especially the game's ranged combat system. But a few issues with the game's combat system to begin with. The range combat system being merely the one on display in that particular instance. But the combat systems in general. Well, now, finally kill you. Save what's left of these poor forlorn souls. Hey. But yeah, so ranged combat is finicky in this game. Which I guess is no surprise, but yeah, the actual targeting mechanics regarding, oh, and of course another shortcut. The actual targeting mechanics regarding ranged weapons is like you have to, laterally it's what you face, but vertically is your camera. And I went over this in episode 0. But yeah, that's how ranged, oh, come on. Oh, wait, I know how to do this. To hold space, I think. No, I have to not hold space. Long way around. Got it backwards. You okay? You good. Okay, apparently I'm saving you now. I wonder what's in here. Maybe it's a quest thing later on. I'll have to keep an eye on that. Okay. Oh, shoot. Got my keys backwards. Well, okay. I guess you're not particularly grateful about the fact that I saved your lives. You want to throw them away? Fine. Be my guest. See if I care. Ah. But yeah, it's surprising actually how far you can get with just crossbow, bow, and sorceries, but yeah, Deacons of the Deep are tough mostly because, and I knew they would be, I figured they'd be the toughest boss in the game for me, because they are a lot of somewhat meaty enemies, but there's a large number of them. Like, that's the biggest problem, is that there's so many of them, but they take several shots to kill, but you're dealing with a relatively low rate of fire weapon. So, like, with a longsword, that's no problem. And when I fought them with Irina, it was a one-shot thing. I met them, I killed them, it was done. But with my other character, it's just... Yeah. So I think this area would actually be hell for a pure ranged build. I mean, if anyone wants to try, they'd probably find a way, and I'm sure there's a way. It's just not very straightforward, to be sure. All right, that's the bridge I was on, because there's an area I want to jump down to. Oh, wait, the area I want to jump down to is way out of the way. I'm not even in the right area here. This is the wrong neighborhood completely. So this is... Oh, that's the ladder I took. This is another bridge. That's another sorcerer. That's the upper area of the house that I was worried stuff would jump down on me on, I think. No, something else. Hey, a shortcut! Nice. Okay, cool. This is the first shortcut I found, I think. Yep. Seriously? I saved your lives. Except yours. You obviously have killed you now. But you know, the life-saving thing is like, it's a one-shot deal, you know? You get your life saved, and if you want to forfeit it, then that's at your discretion. And there's not much I can do to really stop you. Except, of course, stop you. But that's fatal. And generally considered rude. But admittedly, you were being rude first. So, I won't feel guilty about that. Aha, I found the path to you. Or, no, I found what... Aha, I found the path to you. Prepare to die, ungrateful ruffian. Ow. Now you're dead. And probably no more grateful than... Ooh, crow talons. Let's find out about this thing that was trying to kill me. And succeeded several times. Talons used by Corvian knights inflicts 5 perpendicular slashes, causing heavy bleeding. In their infatuation with Sister Frida, the Corvian knights swore to protect the painting from fire, and to this end took to the execution of their own brethren. Skill is Raptor Flurry, which spread left and right talons like a broad set of wings and lots... Okay, what's this? I'm guessing what it is. Of course, you have... Try one hand first. So is this, slashing, punch. That's a pretty cool fist weapon, actually. And that's that, and then the left slash is... Oh. A little nice double thing. And the skill... Oh, wow! That's gonna come up in PvP. You know what that reminds me of? Beast Claws! Once again, Bloodborne. But yeah, it does remind me of the Beast Claws quite a bit, actually. I make all these comments about Bloodborne, yet have never played it. I've just seen so many people play it that it's just... I know so much about it, having never played the game. The last thing I could possibly do with that game is a blind playthrough. But that aside, which kind of sucks, because actually, as a blind playthrough game, it does seem like one of the better ones of the whole FromSoft oeuvre. So it would appear that this is the house I need to get to the rock. It would also appear that I can't get to it. Gotten inside it, but getting to it seems to be out of my reach. But at any rate, we'd have to do that in the next episode. So let's just head on back, maybe head on around, but mostly back. Nope, that's... Yeah, that's another house, a lower side of the house. I mean, I feel like I've been here... Oh, wait. I had no reason to kill you. Sorry, I didn't mean for you to die. You good? Okay, you're good. Alright, yeah, so looks like... You okay? Eh, you're not worth my time. Cool. So, that's that. Well, that's a much better impression of the Ashes of Ariandel DLC. So I hope you enjoyed that. Definitely far more fun, I'm sure, to watch, and as it was for me to play, than the first one. But yeah, you know, first impressions. But like I said, I think it's just really get you back into it. Just punch you in the face to remind you, this is Dark Souls. In case you forgot. Apparently I had forgotten. But now I remember, and now I remember the fondness I have for the bruising and the feeling of swollen welts in my jawline. It's a familiar feeling. Not sure if I call it pleasant. Maybe there's a Stockholm Syndrome thing going on. Anyway, Stockholm Syndrome away, I suppose. As I go. See you next time.